company, it's all about coordination. Who controls the media? Kalau kata kita di barat tu, it's a Rupert Murdoch. He controls cable, TV, he controls almost everything. And apakah yang they propagate here? They propagate the American Hollywood popular culture. Yes, we can agree on that? So in Malaysia, we also have domination. Media Prima, PrimeWorks, dominates most of the TV stations. We have TV7, TV9, TV3, apa lagi? 8TV, yeah, and even some of the media newspapers. So, domination again, yeah. So, dominasi pihak-pihak tertentu yang akan mampu menjual apa sahaja that makes money. Okay, so the Hollywood popular culture works. So it's dominated by the non-Muslims. Very, very sad, right? So bila kita balik kepada pemahaman kita tentang industri film ini, anything that sells, anything that makes money, they will go ahead and do it. Because it is not dominated by Muslims who really, really care about the religion. So, ramai orang yang berkata kepada saya, oh, susahlah, apa ni, banyak sangat. Kalau orang dominated by Muslims, dia kata banyak sangat. Macam sekarang ni pun lembaga paling penapisan ni banyak sangat songeh lah. Dia kata ni tak boleh, tu tak boleh, ni tak boleh. Habis nak buat apa? Dia kata dia. So, kononnya, kita perlu jadi macam orang-orang di Hollywood. Kita perlu, itulah dia kita punya apa ni, focus point. That is our rujukan. It's the Hollywood American popular culture. So, I think my hypothesis is orang-orang di Bollywood tu mereka berjaya because they don't use that. They have their own acuan sendiri. Our acuan is what? Our focal point is what? The Quran lah. The Quran and Sunnah lah. But is anybody doing that? Not in Malaysia. Again, because it is not dominated by Muslims who really care about religion. Now, I come back to the topic of banyak sangat kekangan. Semua tak boleh buat. Dia tak buat apa? So I'm saying that dengan kekangan-kekangan ini, ni tak boleh buat, tu tak boleh buat, ni tak boleh buat. That is why the Muslims created even more intricate designs in Islamic architecture and art. Sebab mereka tidak dibenarkan. Look at the Greeks, yeah? they were doing sculptures lah. Orang Islam tak boleh buat, tak boleh. So dengan kekangan-kekangan ini, it forced Muslims to become more creative. That's why they come with other arabesque, the calligraphy, the geometric designs, because of the kekangan. They had to find other ways. So I'm saying kekangan ini sepatutnya melahirkan orang-orang yang lebih kreatif lagi, bukan orang-orang yang cut and paste. Unfortunately, this is what's happening. Kita jangan nak marah kepada